This episode of Budget MTG Decks is sponsored by TCG Player, the best place to buy your cards in the US. Welcome to Budget MTG Decks. All the cards you see in our videos are a dollar or less, with exception of the commander cards.
Also, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon to be notified when a new video comes out.
Hi, I'm Jasper, and welcome to a special bonus video for Budget MTG Decks. In this video, we will be discussing the new Unified Pauper format as announced by Wizards of the Coast on June 27th. Now, first of all, the Unified Pauper format means that every card ever printed at Common, either online or on paper, is now legal for Pauper. This essentially adds over 400 new cards to the format. Second biggest update is that Pauper is now an officially sanctioned format, which means that local game stores can organize Pauper tournaments for Planeswalker points, which of course vastly increases the audience for the format. Of course, Pauper originated as a Magic Online-only format. This means that it misses a lot of the older sets like Antiquities and Legends, and also a lot of supplemental sets such as Battlebond and Conspiracy. That means that there are a lot of cards which have been printed on Common on paper, but have never been released on Magic Online, making them illegal for Pauper. And in reverse, there's a lot of cards that have printed in Common in special Magic Online sets or treasure chests, but have never gotten a paper printing at Common, which makes them legal for Pauper, but unavailable for paper Pauper. With this new unification, that means that all that confusion is gone, and we've basically got, if it ever been printed at Common, then it's legal in Pauper. Now, this means that over 400 new cards have been added to the Pauper format. Now, three have been banned preemptively. We've got Hymn to Torak, which is a very powerful hand disruption card. We've got Sinkhole, which is a 2-mana land destruction card. And we've got High Tide, which is a crazy combo enabler that sees play in Legacy and Vintage. These three cards, they basically decided ahead of time, no, this will be too format warping, we're not going to wait, we're going to ban them preemptively. But other than that, 412 new cards have been added to the format, and this video is going to show you five of those cards that are going to be available on a budget, which will really enhance your Pauper decks. The first card we're looking at today is Tormod Crypt. For 0 mana, it's an artifact that says tap and sacrifice Tormod Crypt to exile all cards from target player's graveyard. This is a very nice alternative to Relic of Progenitus or Nihil Spellbomb, because for 0 mana it can be dropped at any time and can be left on the board until you need it. And of course, it also leaves your own graveyard alone, which means that you can even run it as a sideboard card in something like Dredge or Zombies. Next up, we have Goblin Grenade, one of the most iconic goblin spells ever printed all the way back in Fallen Empires. It's a sorcery for 1 red mana that says sacrifice a goblin. Goblin Grenade deals 5 damage to any target. Now, this is of course a very powerful burn spell. It does require you to sacrifice a goblin, but if you're playing goblins, then you usually have at least half a dozen on the field, which makes the extra cost nearly negligible. And it gives the swarming goblin decks a really good way to close out games. Next up, we have two cards for the price of one. We have Blue and Red Elemental Blast. Blue Elemental Blast is an instant for 1 blue mana. It says counter target red spell or destroy target red permanent. Of course, Red Elemental Blast is the exact opposite. For 1 red mana, we get an instant that says counter target blue spell or destroy target blue permanent. Now, these are very powerful 1 mana instant speed answers that can be very easily compared to Hydro Blast and Pyro Blast, which are two of the most played sideboard cards in the format. Now, 95% of the time they are functionally identical, with the only main difference being that Hydro and Pyro Blast can target any spell or permanent, which means that it does play better in a deck where cast triggers matters, like Is It Blitz? But 95% of the time you won't be able to tell the difference. And of course, if we're going to talk about niche scenarios, there's also the fact that you can cast a blue or a red Elemental Blast around the Flag Bearer, where normally you'd have to target them with the Pyro or the Hydro Blast. Next up, we have Forked Bolt. For 1 red mana, it's a sorcery that says it deals 2 damage, divided as you choose, among any 1 or 2 targets. Now, this is a relatively new card compared to the others on the list. It's a very weird situation. Basically, it's only been printed as a common in a dual deck, and dual decks aren't available online. Now, it's a sorcery speed burn spell, but it's very flexible because you can basically play it as a shock or even a 2-for-1 in most situations. And because of its flexibility, it's a card that you'll always like top decking because it always does something for you. Finally, we have Breath of Life. For 3 and a white, it's a sorcery that says return target creature cards from your graveyard to the battlefield. Now, of course, it's also a functional reprint of False Defeat, a card from Portal 3 Kingdoms, but that one's not budget, so we're just going to be talking about this one. And it's very unique in the sense that it's an unconditional reanimate spell without any drawback. Now, Pauper has already seen some very limited reanimate spells, cards like Exhume, but these are often very hard to play effectively because they either work synergistically or they can also have huge drawbacks or limitations. Breath of Life has none of this, so if in any of your free turns you discard Ulamog's Crusher, then the fourth turn you can play Breath of Life and bring it back without any strings attached. Now these are five very powerful new pauper cards, and there are of course many more added to the format, which we didn't discuss today, mostly because of our budget limitation. But it doesn't mean that these cards aren't available now and they're going to be a lot of fun to brew with. Of course, as always, all the cards featured in our videos can be found on tcgplayer.com. Which cards are you most excited about playing in the new unified pauper format? Leave a comment below. I'm Jasper, thanks for watching, and this was Budget MTG Decks.
Find all the cards discussed in this video in the description below. Also, show you're a fan of the channel by rocking this awesome Budget MTG Decks merchandise. This show was made possible by the support of our loyal patrons. Head on over to patreon.com/budgetmtgdecks and donate as little as $1 per month.